Welcome on Data Communication Network Lecture Series. Today our topic is the Data Link Layer. This is the topic number Unit 2. It is the first lecture. We know that the Data Link Layer is the second layer of the OSI model. And we already know it is the lower layer. And there is the also one lower layer is the physical layer, which is concerned with the transmission of signals over a transmission link. For the effective data communication, more is needed to control and manage the access. To achieve the necessary control, a layer of logic is added above the physical interfacing. This logic is referred to as data link control, or you can say data link control layer. So we start this topic on data link control. Previously we see that data link layer is the responsible for the moving the frames from hop to hop. Now we are taking this topic to see the more details in data link layer. Before we are going, we have seen the some more relevant things. The first layer of the your this OSI model is what? The physical layer. So physical layer of OSI model is which is I think you have already seen by the previous lectures, or here I am just not going to in deep in the physical layer, because we have our the next unit, that is the unit number 2. So we are taking the some references which is concerned with the transmission of signals over a transmission link. You know that this transmission of signal is nothing but it is the digital data is converted into a digital signals by applying the different line coding techniques. So more you have seen that it is concerned with the transmission of signals transmissions transmission of signals over a transmission link हम जानते हैं कि जो फिजिकल लेयर जो कुछ भी रॉ मटेरियल्स है, जो बिट स्ट्रीम्स है, उसको ट्रांसमिशन सिग्नल्स के लायक बनाकर और अपने जो इंटरफेसिंग जो डिवाइसेस हैं, जैसे कि आपका ट्रांसमिशन मीडिया है, आपका एंटीना है, उसकी इलेक्ट्रिकल मैकेनिकल कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स को डिफाइंड करने के बाद ये इस डेटा को सेंड करती है। लेकिन अगर हम ब्रॉड वे में देखें तो इफेक्टिव कम्युनिकेशन करने के लिए, फॉर इफेक्टिव डेटा कम्युनिकेशन करने के लिए ये काफ़ी नहीं है। क्यों? क्योंकि हमको नेसेसरी एक ओवरऑल हमको ये देखना है कि मेरा डेटा सही सलामत दूसरे एंड तक गया है कि नहीं, और उसके फ्लो को कंट्रोल करना, ये भी चेक करना कि जो डेटा हम भेज रहे हैं क्या उसका एक्सेस कंट्रोल हमारे पास है कि नहीं है, या हमको ये भी चेक करना कि इसमें कोई अगर एरर आ गई है तो उस एरर को हम इसी एंड पे रिमूव कर दें, क्योंकि इस एंड के बाद एरर रिमूव होना आगे के प्रोसेस में बहुत डिफिकल्ट है। दूसरा, जो सिस्टम या जो कम्युनिकेशन हम कर रहे हैं वो एक नेटवर्क के अंदर है, तब तो इसका जो एड्रेस है, मैक एड्रेस है, इट इज़ मोर देन सफिशिएंट। बट लेकिन अगर ये इसके दूसरे नेटवर्क में है तो जो सेम डीएल, जो सेम डेटा लिंक है, वो सेम डेटा लिंक लेयर है वो सफिशिएंट नहीं है, क्योंकि दूसरे नेटवर्क पे दूसरा डेटा लिंक लेयर, दूसरा डेटा एड्रेस एड्रेस मैक एड्रेस वहाँ पे काम कर रहा है। तो अब एक नेटवर्क से दूसरे नेटवर्क में हमको जाने के लिए हमको एक परमिशन की ज़रूरत पड़ती है, और वो परमिशन गेटवे के थ्रू मिलती है। सो ऐसे एक सिनारियो में हमको ज़रूरत होती है, वी नीड टू कंट्रोल एंड मैनेज दी आवर एक्सेस टू एक्सचेंज दी दिस डेटा फ्रॉम वन मशीन टू दी डिफरेंट मशीन विच इज एक्चुअली ऑन दी अदर नेटवर्क। सो इस कंट्रोल करने के लिए ही हम डेटा लिंक लेयर पे दो इस लेयर का दो डिवीजन करते हैं, एक अपर लेयर कहलाती है और एक लोअर लेयर कहलाती है। सो द डेटा लिंक लेयर्स इज नाउ डिवाइडेड इनटू द टू पार्ट्स, टू लेयर्स। अपर लेयर इज नोन एज द मल्टीपल एक्सिस या मीडियम एक्सिस या यू कैन से मैक एक्सिस कंट्रोल्ड लेयर। ये लेयर ही उसकी एक्चुअली एनआईसी कार्ड के थ्रू उसकी फिजिकल एड्रेसिंग के लिए रिस्पॉन्सिबल है। सो जब मशीन एक प्रॉपर यूनिक आइडेंटिटी के साथ अपनी मशीन लैंग्वेज के साथ अगर वर्क करती है तो ऐसे सिनारियों में हमको पूरा इंटायर्ड स्ट्रक्चर्स के बारे में पता चल जाता है। तो जब फिजिकल लेयर इस काम को नहीं कर पाई तो हमको एटलीस्ट डेटा लिंक लेयर की ज़रूरत पड़ी, क्यों कि हमको अचीव करना था एक नेसेसरी कंट्रोल। सो टू अचीव्ड द to achieve the necessary control, necessary control there is a layer, there is the layer of logic layer of logic is added. Above the physical physical interfacing so this हो ये एक मिनट फिजिकल इंटरफेसिंग दिस लॉजिक इज रेफर to as a refer to a interfacing data control or you can say it is there is a one more name is data link link control protocol. So when the data link control protocol is used, transmission medium between the system is referred to as a data link. So when a data link data link control protocol control protocol किसके लिए यूज करेंगे? इज यूज use the transmission medium data link controlled protocol is used to transmission medium between system is a refer 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 to as a data link. So what we read here, we read the algorithm to achieving the reliable, efficient communication between the two adjacent machine at this data link layer. See the diagram, this picture. They are the seventh layer in OSI model. Physical data link layer, network layer, transport layer, session layer, presentation layer, or application layer. The data link layer is the second layer of this OSI model. It is the in between the network and the physical layer, and it is connected to the routers of the network to the another group of network. It is the data link layer now. What prepare the network data from the physical network. So the greatest responsibility of this data link layer prepares network data on within among the networks and to transfer to the other network machine. Now how the data is taken? It is at the which arrow is connected to the system. This arrow is connected to the application layer of this sender. So the arrow direction is like this way. So the first layer of this diagram is the application layer. So the arrow is coming from top to the bottom. If the attachment of the transmission line is from to this, then it goes to from top to bottom. Then the first layer is physical data link layer, third, fourth, fifth, sixth. And why we are saying it is the layer between the physical network layer? Because of the fundamental concept on of your OSI model. So the data, whatever the coming from the network layer, it goes to the data link layer in the form of frames, and then it goes to the physical layer. And same thing is happened in the other destination receiving machine. It takes the data from the physical layer and it framing whatever the data is coming from, it convert the frames, then it's delivered to the upper network layer. So you have seen it is the importance of this data link layer in this OSI or TCP IP layer is that to convert your objective. That objective is to effective data communication between the directly connected transmitting receiving station. So the third layer of network layer, it ensure the that it is the error free and we done the framing. So the it convert into the frame. That frame is known as packet, and inside the packet there is the our data, and it puts the two block from upper this right hand side it put the header, and left hand side it put the trailer. Trailer means it is the error free, or header means it confirm the data is the in the form of your packet, and to ensure the your data is started at from header and it ended at trailer. So the confirmation is given by the this to header and trailer. So if you see the need for data link control, the sum of the requirement and objective for the effective data communication between the two directly connected transmitting receiving station. This objective is framing reliable delivery, flow control, error reduction, half duplex and full duplex. So this is services of this data link layer. If you talk about the if you see to need the to need for data link control, sum of requirement sum of requirements and objectives for effective data communication between communication between between two directly directly connected transmitting receiving effective. Okay, transmitting effective, receiving station. Sir, आवाज रिकॉर्ड हो. ओके, नाउ चेक वन बाय वन. फ्रेमिंग एंड लिंक एक्सेस. डेटा लिंक लेयर प्रोटोकॉल्स इनकैप्सुलेट ईच नेटवर्क फ्रेम विद इन ए लिंक लेयर फ्रेम. सो फ्रेमिंग मीन्स फ्रेमिंग synchronization. This is the design issue. The data are sent to blocks are called the frames. The beginning and end is ensured by each frame. It must be put a header and tailor. So we can say the data link layer protocols encapsulate each network frame within a link layer frame before the transmission across the link. A frame consists of data field in which the network layer datagram is inserted and a number of data fields. So it is the specified the structure of the frame as well as the channel access control by which frame is to be transmitted over the link. The reliable delivery means the data link layer provide the reliable delivery services. That means they transmit the network layer datagram without any error. It's not only detect the error, but it also correct the error at the data link layer. So the a reliable delivery service is accomplished with transmission and with acknowledgments. So the data link layer mainly provide the reliable delivery service over the links as they have higher error rates and they can be corrected locally link at which an error occurs rather than the forcing to retransmit the data. If the data is lost it again retransmit because the we got the negative acknowledgments. So the retransmit of the data is the last count for the this reliable delivery services. We need the flow control because we should know how the receiver can be received the absorb the data from the sending machines. So it first to ensure how much data can be absorbed by the receiver at the other ends. So it a receiving node can receive the frame at which the data rate is required. If you require the faster data rate, then it can be process the frame. Without flow control, receiver buffer can overflow. If we cannot control the flow control, then at the receiver end, the buffer is showing the overflow and the frame got lost. So to overcome this problem, data link layer uses the flow control to prevent the sending node on the one side of the link from the overwhelming the receiving node on the other side of the link. Error reduction. Error can be introduced by the signal attenuation and noise. So the data link layer protocols provide the mechanism to detect one or more errors. So it is achieved by the adding the redundant bits, that adding the error reduction bits in the frame, and then receiving the node can perform an error check. Error corrections is the similar as the error reduction, but except the receiving node not only detect the error but also determine where the error has been occur in the frame. It can also be see the at what position and what type of error is taking place. In the this layers half duplex and full duplex, for the transmission in a full duplex mode, both the node can transmit so that data at the same time. In the half duplex, only one mode transmit at the same time. So you can say this is the actual figure of your data link. There is a it is the in between the network layer number 3 and physical layer. So what he transmit, it only exchange the 0-1 sequence, and what the frame is started, he putting the header 110110101.